this video, I'm gonna compare two apps that I use a lot. It's gonna be Canva versus Kittl so that you can see the differences and figure out which app is the right one for you. Let's go. Thanks for joining me on this video. My name is Juno with Detour Shirts. I've been designing and selling t-shirts online since 2005. And in this video, we're gonna do a comparison video, Canva versus Kittl. Ever since I did this video right here, where I compared Kittl to some other apps, people have been asking me, can you do one Kittl versus Canva? So this is the video. I use both of these apps a lot on my videos. You can see how to use them. This is not gonna be a video on how to use them, more of what kind of the features are there on Canva, what are the features on Kittl, and you can decide for yourself which one is the best for you. So they each have their own strengths and weaknesses. I'm gonna go over those. And at the end, I'm gonna give you a chart so that you can see all of the things that I talked about in this video. So my hope in this video is to give you all the facts that I know about these two applications, and then you decide for yourself which one is right for you. So let's get into Kittl and Canva right now, and I'll show you the differences. So let's talk about pricing first. Let's get this out of the way. Most people go to this last to show you all the features, but I'm not trying to sell you anything. I'm just gonna show you what the prices are. So first, Canva. There's a lot of things you can do with Canva free. You can actually build it to the right size. You cannot do transparent background, so that's a big thing on Canva. And there's a ton more graphics on Canva Pro, right? Canva Free is very limited on graphics, even though there's a lot of graphics. That's basically it. So Canva Pro, we're gonna compare Canva Pro, which is $119.99 a year for one person. T-shirt designers like myself are just on their own, so this is the one we're gonna compare it to, $119.99 or $120, right? If we go to Kittl, here there's pricing. They also have a free version, which is very limited, very low res export, so you can't really use the free version. It's more for practice on how the thing works. You can't really use it to upload your t-shirt designs with the free. You may wanna go Pro, which is that $120 like Canva, but I use this one, $288 annually. And the reason I use Expert is because I can use all the premium templates and I have more space. So these are the two versions, Pro or Expert, and Canva is just the Pro version. So the next thing I wanna compare is templates. So let's go back to Canva. Canva does have t-shirt templates. So if you go templates and go to t-shirt, you can see all templates. I'm in t-shirt here. You can see there are some templates. Most of these are very, very simple. It's something that anyone can do. Not a lot of, like, you could build these on your own and pretty quickly, right? I mean, there's some art ones, but most of them are just text with some art stuff in here. So, I mean, these do sell on t-shirts, but if you take a look on Kittl, like super, more premium is what I'm saying. Like some of these would be really hard to do in Photoshop, whereas these you could, you know, this is just text and lines, right? Someone without a graphic design background could make these, but what you're getting here on Kittl is like super detailed stuff where you have like arched text and things like that. The graphics are amazing. The layouts are amazing. So these are just a step above, right? If you can tell the difference between that. So I'm gonna give the templates, in my opinion, are a lot better here on Kittl. If that's what you want this kind of premium graphics, definitely Kittl takes the win for this one. But if you're okay with doing these kinds of templates, these kinds of designs, then this is what you'll get at Canva. So along with the premium templates are the premium graphics and text effects. So in Canva, you're very limited to like the effects that you can do. You got some of these things and, you know, it's nice. And you can curve it or you can make it straight. But if we come here to Kittl, you can see you can do a lot more things with your text. They have a lot better fonts, in my opinion. Just premium fonts, right? They may not have as many fonts, but they got some premium fonts here. And you got some text edit transformation stuff here where you can do it like this, or you can customize it, or you can move it around like that, or you can do a distort, or like the options are a lot better, as well as these text effects where you can change stuff. So if you're looking for this kind of granularity of changing your stuff, then I think Kittl beats Canva on that point where you can kind of move things around. And this one I'm giving to Kittl where you can change your text effects and your fonts and things like that. So another thing that Kittl does really well is texture. So if you come in here, you can see if you really want this vintage look or other looks here with the textures, you can do the grunge texture, right? And just It's really intuitive. You can just come in here and like pick as many as you want. You can try them out. And with this clip content area, you can actually export it with the textures clipped out of it. So that's something really neat in Kittl that you can't do in Canva. Canva kinda has some textures. You can see in this one, they're adding textures on here, but you can't really knock it out of the thing below it. So it's nice on screen, but if you're gonna use it for print on demand for t-shirts, then it's not something that you can actually take out of it. It's just gonna look black on here. And so if you have like a blue background, let me show you. If you have like a blue background, you can see the texture isn't knocked out. It's just that texture, right? So the texture part of it, all the graphic parts of it, this kind of stuff, I would give to Kittl. You can see they just really focused on doing this really well, the fonts and the textures and the just the graphic design of it all. So they're built for people who love this kind of design elements, right? If you look into their stuff right here, that's kind of how they're built. They're built for really nice graphic design. So that's the strength of Kittl. I'm gonna talk about some of the strengths of Canva. Most of this have been graphic design focused for Kittl, but let me tell you some of the strengths of Canva. So let's talk about graphics. One of the biggest strengths on Canva is that they have a ton of stuff. Their library is huge. So if you come in here and just search for anything, they pretty much have it. So if you did Christmas, right? Like you have photos for Christmas, videos for Christmas, graphics for Christmas, go into here, it scrolls forever, right? Whereas if you came in here, Kittl does have stuff, like they do have designs that you can go look for elements and you could type in Christmas here and they got good stuff. But I mean, I don't think anybody can compare to Canva. They've been in the business forever and so they have a lot more stuff. So if you're looking for like quantity versus quality, maybe, and then they have quality stuff too, but just the quantity of Canva, I'll give it to them. They have more photos. Like if you go to photos here for Kittl, not nearly as many photos as Canva would have, right? So if you did photos here, this one would just go on forever and ever. So huge library of stuff. They have more photos, more patterns. Like if you typed in patterns here, or maybe even just Christmas patterns, just to be more specific, right? If you're looking for patterns, Canva would beat Kittl in that because you can go in here and you can see not as many patterns, obviously, because they just haven't been in the business that long and their library just not as big as Canva, which no one's is. No one's as big as Canva. So I'm gonna give that one to Canva, just the library of stuff. They just have a lot more of it. So another thing that Canva does really well is they have frames. So if you're not familiar with frames, you can bring something in here. And then if you found like a pattern or something, let's do that. Let's say you like this pattern here, this photo, you can actually drag it into here and it kind of clips and masks it. Another thing that's really cool in Canva that you can't do in Kittl yet is, let's say you have a graphic here and you put this here, you can actually crop. So these are things that I'm sure Kittl will be doing. You can crop that. But in here in Kittl, like if you want to crop this, there's no way to do it currently. You can transform it and set it and move it around, but there's no way to, like, if you only want some of it, no, that's not a graphic, but this one is. So there's no way to like crop this graphic, right? Like if you do that, it doesn't crop it out. You're gonna have to do some hide and show kind of things with like overlays and things like that. But currently there's no way to do this on Kittl. I'm sure they're working on it. They're still in beta, so there's more things that they're gonna add later on. But as the recording of this video, you cannot crop or mask things like this. Like I can't put this in a number or a shape or something like that right now. So I'm gonna give this to Canva right now for the frames and the masking and the cropping and things like that. So another thing that I wanted to talk about is mobile devices. So Canva has a really cool app. I have it right here on my iPad. I've used it before. Really simple, very intuitive, just like their desktop app. Kittl does not have one currently. Again, they're still in beta. I'm sure they're working on stuff. But right now, I'm going to give this one to Canva because their mobile app, you can take this on the go and do it while you're watching TV or wherever you are. And still, you're not tied down to a desktop or a laptop to do this kind of stuff. You can go on the road, on the train, on wherever you are, and kind of great designs on the fly. So this one I'm giving to Canva just for their mobile app. It's pretty cool. Those things that I talked about before were some of the main stuff, but there's a lot of other things that you can talk about with Canva and with Kittl. First with Canva, I think what they're really good at and that Kittl doesn't have is a lot of these stuff for like the office thing. So you got your content planner, like lots of different tools, discovery apps. It's just huge, right? You got different apps that you can plug into to Canva that you can use for photos, touching up things, just a bunch of other stuff. I can't go into it because there's just so many apps. And then the smart mockups, you can't do this in Kittl yet. I'm sure they may think about this, where you can mock up things on your phone or on things. So on different products as well, probably t-shirts. I didn't see it on here, but I'm sure there's t-shirts on here somewhere. You can do mock-ups that you can put on social media and things like that. And then just things that you can do with AI. I've probably showed you this before where you can suggest something and Canva will make a thing with it with AI. Canva just has so many tools. So it's just very big, has lots of different things. If you're the type of person that wants to do all these kinds of things, you know, for your office, maybe for a little bit of video, a little bit of this, a little bit of that, Canva is great for that kind of stuff. Kittl, on the other hand, is more precise. They're more about doing graphic design work. So for the graphic designer that wants to do like logos or labels for packaging or t-shirts or posters, like it was built for that audience, the graphic design audience that wants to do some of these kinds of things, but don't want to get into Photoshop and Illustrator to do it themselves. Because like, honestly, doing some of these things on your own will take a lot of time, but you can really just jumpstart it here on templates and do it, you know, like change the thing. You don't have to worry about how am I gonna fix this text in here or do the effects, these kinds of effects on your own. It's already all built in. And this is why graphic designers, people with a graphic design background are so excited about this, because doing this on your own, these kinds of designs on your own, can take a lot of time. Maybe if you're not in the graphic design community, you may not know how long it takes, but you can see like very detailed stuff, the colors and everything, some of these. So real premium graphics, and for this kind of audience, you know, if you're doing this kind of work, graphic design work, this is what Kittl's specialty is getting premium graphics, vintage kind of graphics, those kinds of fonts, premium fonts. For that. So Canva versus Kittl. So the free version, there is a free version on both, but on Kittl it's very limited and you can't really use it to design t-shirts. Canva you can. The price, we compared, you know, $119.99 per year, should probably put $120 per year on there for Canva Pro. And Kittl had a Pro version at $120 a year, but I'm using the Expert version at $288 a year. So that's the difference. If you want to use the premium templates and have more space, the templates on Canva are okay. They're pretty good. You saw some of the, basically they're stuff that everyone can do, but on Kittl, they're a lot better. Professional graphic designers have made these templates and you can see the quality is just a lot better. So I'm getting Kittl the check on that one. As far as fonts and text effects, I'm giving that one to Kittl as well. They just have premium fonts, in my opinion. They're the font guys. They know what fonts look great on designs and graphic designs, and they have better effects for their fonts too, the way you can move it around and add textures and things like that. Speaking of textures, Kittl also have a lot more textures that you can use and clip out and use for your design. So if you want to make distressed t-shirt designs, Kittl's the way to go. Vintage designs, Kittl's the way to go for that. Of course, Canva has more fonts, but their effects for their fonts are really simple, made just to do, you know, curves and drop shadows and really simple stuff like that. But on the other hand, Canva has a lot more graphics. Like no one I can think of that has more graphics than Canva for that price. And their library is huge and they have more photos and more patterns. Kittl does have that. Of course, you can use those graphics that they have, but just the quantity, Canva beats them out. As far as frames and masking and cropping, I'm giving that one to Canva. Kittl doesn't do it yet. It's in beta, of course, but I'm sure they're working on it. As well as a mobile app, Canva has one. Kittl does not have one yet, but their mobile app on Canva, if you want to take it on the go, I'm giving it to that. And as far as just other stuff, They have better presentation stuff. You can do website stuff. You can do mockups, and there's lots of app add-ons. You can go down a big rabbit hole on Canva and do lots of different things, which is why a lot of people like it. It's just like a Swiss Army knife of different things for graphics. So if you want to do photo enhancement, they even have the AI that can draw it for you and make designs for you, which is pretty cool. Kittl is better suited for graphic designers to make labels and icons and posters and t-shirts. So my consensus is, who's Canva for? Their target audience is the person who wants to do it all and wants lots of different options, wants a giant library of stuff, and just, you know, wants simple things, but maybe they want to do a little bit of things for Instagram, or a little bit of things for like a graphic presentation, or for their office, or whatever, the calendar. They just want maybe a video clip or whatever. They want everything, the all-in-one package, right? Whereas Kittl is more for a person who wants premium graphics, maybe the person that wants to do vintage distress t-shirts, that like that kind of specific project, right? Or maybe they're designing it for a label for a packaging or things like that. So they're very more niche and more specific, but have premium stuff for that product. So those are the two differences between, in my opinion, for Canva and Kittl. Use this table here and kind of decide for yourself what's best for you. So that is it for this video. Hopefully this video is really helpful for you on deciding whether it's Canva or Kittl for you. I use both and you could use both, but if you want to decide between one or the other, hopefully this video is really helpful. And if it was, make sure to give it a thumbs up. And if you're not subscribed to this channel already, make sure to hit that subscribe button right there. The question of the day for this video is, which one would you choose, Canva or Kittl? Leave that in the comments, or both. You can leave, say, I would use both. You can do that as well, or neither. I guess that's an option as well. So thanks again for watching. And if you want to see more videos about Canva and Kittl, click on these videos right here. And as always, guys, keep creating and keep learning. I'll see you on the next one. Bye.